Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you a tutorial on how I use the program Audacity to convert 440Hz into 432Hz. So for this tutorial I'm going to be using a piece of Beethoven's Fur Elise because it's free and it's not copywritten, I hope. So to get started I will just give you a listen to what the original 440Hz Fur Elise sounds like. So that's probably enough for you guys to get a bit of an understanding of what it should sound like. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the first of three methods that can be used on the program Audacity. So the first one I'm going to use is pitch change. So I've already gone ahead and created three empty tracks, stereo tracks. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy the original. Just by selecting it all, you can press Ctrl A and then Ctrl C to copy it. And I'm just going to copy it into each respective stereo track. So now we have the same track in all four, but I've labeled them so we're not going to get them confused later on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight the first track that has the name pitch change. Then I'm going to go into effects. I'm going to go change pitch. I've already lined it up because I use this program quite often, but what you want to make sure is that the semitones look like this, -0.32, and that the percent change looks like this, -1.818. You can also manually do it by putting in 440 to 432. You can use high quality stretching, which takes a few minutes, but I don't find that it adds that much quality. And just press OK. It only takes a few seconds, and there you have it. I might just go ahead and show you all three methods, and then we'll give each of them a respective listen to. Moving downwards to the speed change track, we're just going to highlight this, press solo, and I'm going to go into effects, change speed, and here you'll notice that we actually have the same percent change, -1.818, and we just want to make sure that the standard vinyl is not applicable because we're not ripping from a vinyl, and then we'll just press OK. Again, it just takes a few seconds to complete. And perfect. Now I'm going to move on to the fourth track, which will be the third and final method using the program Audacity. We'll just highlight that track, go into effects, scroll down through the plugins, go to sliding time. Here we want to make sure the initial tempo change and the final tempo change are both 0%. The semitone change should look like this. The percent change has remained consistent throughout. So we'll just do that. And this can take a few minutes. I will probably fast forward through this with some editing, but we'll give it a go. And voila, we're done. So now we've got all the tracks changed. Perfect. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll give each of them a listen to and we'll go from there. Starting with the original track, I'm just going to press solo to make sure we're only getting the audio from that, and then go ahead and give that a listen to. Thank you. give the second track a listen to, which is the pitch change track. Going to go down to the speed change track. And finally, the sliding time scale. Now we've listened to all four tracks, we need to decide which one we're going to keep. I personally prefer the sound of the speed change track the most, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and just press delete track on all the others. Actually, before I delete the original, what I might do is I might just do a back-to-back comparison of the 440 versus the speed change 432. Now we've given those two back to back a bit of a listen to, we can hopefully hear the differences between the two. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete the original. We do not want this one, so we'll just delete that. We're now left with this one. We can just slide it open so we can get a better look. Audacity has quite a good range of features. You can go in here and go to spectrogram. We can highlight the frequencies to inspect them further. You'll see down here, we can see what the high and low frequencies are. We can also select all, go into analyze, and go to plot spectrum. Have a look at the entire piece. Some things that I do, depending on the piece of work, is I like to go into normalize. So it wasn't that dramatic, as you can see, but to me it makes the world of difference. Now we're going to export the track. You're just going to file, export as all the other projects I've been working on. I go to 32-bit. I'll just show you while I'm here. These are the other files that you can export as using the program Audacity. So I use FLAC and WAVE. They're the two main ones that I use. What I always like to do is, onto the end of the file, I like to add 432Hz, just so that we know that we're not getting them confused. Whoopsies. Yes, we'll replace that one. Now we've got that saved, we can upload it to YouTube, we can listen for personal consumption, we can do whatever we like with it. I hope this video has been beneficial to you guys, and please let me know if there's anything else that you want me to make a tutorial on or explain in further details. I know some people get confused over the numbers, so perhaps I can go into further detail. One of the viewers didn't know how to convert his own music, so I just said to him that I would show him quickly on Audacity. But if this is a topic you guys would like me to delve deeper into, go further into the numbers, the mathematics, the physics of it, I am more than happy to do that as well. That's all for today. Thank you guys for watching, especially because it's my first tutorial and I was a little bit nervous, still am, but I think it was a success and I can't wait to post it and see how it goes. So thank you guys so much, and please be sure to like it and leave any feedback below.